we are trying to build a public transport which is broken, disrupted, and nobody has paid attention to. And it's a very deep problem. When you go inside the buses, you have to deal with untrained crew, driver, conductors, filthy, dirty buses. And then when you go, you have to carry the change, which nobody wants to carry. So what we are trying to change is that I'm giving you accuracy of your travel, that this time your bus will come. I'm giving you live tracking, accuracy se. Then I'm giving you passenger indicator, which is another innovation which we love about. I love about this entire feature, that I will tell you how crowded your bus is. We are also innovating with conductorless buses in India. So you might be thinking, oh, government run the buses. You know, 70% and more buses are run by private operators.
Hello and welcome to Mint. You're watching Founder Diaries, where we bring to you insights into the entrepreneurial journeys of Indian startup founders. Today we have with us Ms. Priya Singh, the co-founder and director of Chalo. So Priya, thank you so much for talking to us today. I'm super excited for the conversation that we are going to have about Chalo and also the life that you have built so far with all the startups that you've been a part of. Let's first start with Chalo itself. Where did that word come from? How did you name Chalo as Chalo?
First of all, thank you for inviting me, and I'm very happy that you gave me opportunity to talk about it. I think Chalo came from the fact that we are working for mobility. And when you work for mobility and when you see the Indian context, Chalo is a very common word which we use. Ki chalo. Chalo ye karte hain, chalo wo karte hain, chalo let's take it. So I think it was a very common name, and it very well fitted to the objective of this entire business model, wherein you are talking about mobility all the time, right? And not only buses, but the integrated mobility, that whether you go by ferry, whether you go by auto or rented cab, we are connecting everything. So it's not limited to only bus, but the integrated mobility was in the center. And it took a while to get this name because somebody else had this IP address, and somehow we got it. Fortunately, and we named it Chalo.
So your entrepreneurial journey actually started after you met Mohit, right? So
yes.
Talk to us about that a little bit.
So we, I got married very early. Like I passed out from college and I got married. And then one day Mohit said that I want to leave my job and I want to do it, do something else. I said, yeah, do it. He couldn't believe. He said, are you sure? Because we were married for 2 months only.
Okay.
And he was earning and I was doing some social work job, which is like, you can imagine if you are interning with some NGO, how much you will earn. And we were in Bombay. So I said, oh no, you should do it. And we will, I'll figure out that how do I manage finances. Then he kept on figuring out things.
How did you decide on finally joining Chalo as a director, as a co-founder?
So we came to Bombay when his first check came, because his investor said that you need to be in Bombay. And I was in state level job, and it was like Government of India's job. And it was a very glorified opportunity for me. So Mohit said, I don't want you to leave your career and job, because I am also very passionate about what I do. But I was very clear that I want to be there with where the family is always. That I want to be there and I want to continue being together, and like it was a priority. So I said, okay, let me leave. We'll figure out. I came Bombay with him, and that's when he said, why don't you join Chalo? And then there was a sudden pressure that you have to come formally now, because it's been going on for a while. And Dhruv, who is current co-founder of Chalo, he is like there was a football match, final football World Cup. I remember 2010 June. He said, today you have to sign the paper. We are sending an email. It was 2 o'clock in the night. He said, now you have to sign, because it's been going on for a while. And you can't keep doing that, because we can't say anything to you, because you're not signing the paper. You're not taking the designation. So I said, you are happy with my work? They said, yes, we are very satisfied, very sure that you're going to be building this company with us. And what is the problem of not, of getting the money and getting the designation and formally coming up. Mm-hmm. So I said, okay, chalo. I also got convinced that they, with the organization they are building, there's lot to do. Standing with people for their rights, building a kind of culture, which, and Rinald is from there, so he knows that what kind of culture we have built. Mm-hmm. So it was good. So I joined finally.
Mm-hmm. You joined as the...
As the AVP. Okay. For people and culture. Mm-hmm. And that's how it happened.
Mm-hmm. Then, and then from there to Chalo.
Then I left Carvalho in 2017. I went to Stanford for a small course because I thought I am not very good with strategy and finances.
Okay.
So I thought I sold my shares and I got some money. Mm-hmm. So I bought another car because I'm very car. I just love cars.
Okay.
So this was my fourth car. Mm-hmm. And I bought with that money one car, and then I went for studies because I thought I'll just enhance my skills.
But why did you decide to take up that course? Did you plan on starting up after that, or did you want to?
No, nothing like that. I was doing Rangreza. I wanted to do some with some clothing industry because I'm very fond of buying new clothes, and sometimes it happens that I buy something and I wear for twice and thrice and they are kept in my wardrobe. And I was struggling that what to do next now with them. And I thought, why can't I sell on like 60-70% reduction and raise the money for giving another time to back to society?
Yeah.
That's how the model came. And then I spoke to a couple of people and they were also very excited. And Mohit said that you should try it. And I started working on it.
Why did you end up actually starting up in Bombay itself with, you know, I'm sure both of you as in. In Chalo as well, in Bombay itself. Why Bombay? I'm sure the bus network, of course, would be a reason.
No, that was not a reason. We came here when we were building Carvalho. And Bombay is very new age. Bombay people are, and we just opened our office in Goa. We have office in Bangalore. So, you know about Bangalore. You know, I don't know whether you know about Goa or not. Bombay people are very enterprising. Maybe Bangalore is more technology and people say, though it is the Palo Alto of India or, you know, startup hub. I think what you can get in Bombay, you can never get anywhere in India. Because Bombay is very accepting. They never mock you when you want to experiment or do something. This is, I'm telling you from heart. Third is you get opportunity, right? And serious opportunity, right? Everybody has a place to grab an opportunity and do their best in Bombay, right? Fourth is Bombay is safe. Randomly people help you in Bombay. I don't know whether you have seen or not. I have been stuck on a lot of difficult situations. On roads, in malls. People will just come suddenly, they will help and they will disappear.
True.
I have seen this many times, which has never happened in even small towns.
So I also wanted to understand Chalo's expansion plan, right? So last year, I think... you guys have raised a good amount of funding. And that was especially for international expansion.
Right? Yeah.
So what has happened so far? What are your plans going ahead?
So look, this is a long-term journey. We are trying to build a public transport, which is broken, disrupted. And nobody has paid attention to. And it's a very deep problem. It's a critical problem in India, wherein the per capita income is $200, and people have given up considering other social problems. That transport is a problem to talk about, right? Nobody talks about transportation as a problem because they know ki bus niklenge to kuch nahi milega, right? And we have to figure out either shared auto, shared rickshaw, and in India, 2.9% people own cars. So more than 98% people are dependent on public transport, which is a simple data, right? So 80%, 90% people depend on public transport and they do not have modes of transportation, especially buses, which can go to. And metros are not the answer because metros are built for service class or the kind of ticketing metro is having. It is little expensive than people who are like normal factory workers, paramedical staff,
yeah.
shop owners or labor class who travel from one place to another place, mm-hmm. buses are the most viable options. But buses are not fixed yet in this country. So when you go outside, you don't know where your bus is.
Mm-hmm.
Of course, you would like to take bus if you know where your bus is.
Mm-hmm.
And bus is the only industry jahan abhi bhi chhutta chalta hai.
Mm-hmm.
Right?
Yeah.
So it is not digitized.
Mm-hmm.
So when you go inside the buses, you have to deal with untrained crew, driver, conductors, filthy, dirty buses.
Yeah.
And then when you go, you have to carry the change, which mm-hmm. nobody wants to carry. We are just carrying mobile.
Yeah.
Even normal like people who are working in the salons and, you know, housemates, still they are carriers. Paying by, you know, GPay and UPI.
Mm-hmm.
So what we are trying to change is that I'm giving you accuracy of your travel, that this time your bus will come.
Yep.
Right.
Mm-hmm.
Second amazing feature we have built, because they are doing a lot of innovations to mm-hmm. solve this problem, and it's a big problem.
Mm-hmm.
Surprisingly, you might be thinking, oh, government run the buses.
Mm-hmm.
You know, 70% and more buses are run by private operators, mm-hmm. except big cities like Bombay, Delhi, Calcutta,
mm-hmm.
Bangalore, where mm-hmm. government is running. But mm-hmm. most of the cities are run by private operators, or through tender, the OEMs, like private operators, are running mm-hmm. buses.
Mm-hmm.
So I'm giving you live tracking, accurate mm. CSA.
Yeah.
Then I'm giving you passenger indicator, which mm. is another innovation which we love about. I love about this entire feature, that I will tell you how crowded your bus is.
Mm.
So my GPS, my ATIM and the video auditing team, they collaborate with the data
mm-hmm.
And they check that how crowded your bus is.
Mm-hmm.
So I give you predictability that you don't take this bus, you 2 minutes after another bus is coming and you can take that bus.
Yeah.
Second feature I love about. Third is, because unless you solve this problem, even if buses come mm-hmm. and it is overcrowded,
mm-hmm.
then again you will feel, you know, frustrated. Right. Bus to bata di, par ab kaise jaun, isme to koi nahi hai.
Mm-hmm.
So you can actually see 5 buses
mm-hmm.
coming,
mm-hmm.
right? And kis bus mein aapko jana hai, you can manage your travel, you can manage your time.
Mm-hmm.
Kya 9:20 ki bus se nahi, 9:26 se jaati hu, jisse, you know, mujhe जाने में प्रॉब्लम,
यू कैन प्लान बेटर.
हाँ, प्लान बेटर. थर्ड इज डिजिटाइजेशन. बसेस के अंदर यदि आप डिजिटाइजेशन सॉल्व कर देंगे तो दो चीजें होंगी, क्योंकि मोस्ट ऑफ द गवर्नमेंट बसेस एंड प्राइवेट ऑपरेटर्स बसेस आर रनिंग इन लॉसेस. सो इट इज अ टू वे स्वॉर्ड वेर इन पीपल आर नॉट गेटिंग फैसिलिटी एंड गवर्नमेंट इज नॉट गेटिंग मनी और ऑपरेटर्स आर नॉट गेटिंग मनी. सो आवर फोकस इज ऑल्सो टू मेक these buses viable
mm-hmm.
and profitable and making breaking even
mm-hmm.
so that people can get interested in running more buses.
Mm-hmm.
Otherwise, if you're running something in losses, why would you get more buses, right?
Yeah.
So when you do digitization, then you get money,
mm-hmm.
right?
Mm-hmm.
And you reduce pilferage in mm-hmm. the buses, because it's not manual.
Yeah.
Nobody is dealing with the cash.
Yeah.
So that's another objective.
Mm-hmm.
We are also innovating with conductorless buses mm-hmm. in India.
Mm-hmm.
For example, Bombay mein hum kareeb 100 bus run kar rahe hain jo conductorless hain. Usme tap out ke saath aap jate hain. So you have to just take your mobile or card, you just tap in and tap out mm-hmm. with another gate.
Other companies earlier tried to solve this problem.
There are some companies who are solving, but getting live tracking right,
mm-hmm.
I think the way we have got it right,
mm-hmm.
nobody else did so okay. far.
Mm-hmm.
So people are solving in bits and pieces.
Mm-hmm.
So somebody is solving ticketing, somebody is solving yeah. UPI transactions, somebody is solving live tracking. We are solving everything. So mm-hmm. it's a comprehensive
full stack.
Full stack, bilkul. Full mm-hmm. stack hai. Jo bhi aapko chahiye, aap le lo, plug and play model hai. ऑफ कोर्स हम सिटी टू सिटी चेंज कर देते हैं, कभी किसी सिटी को कुछ चाहिए, किसी सिटी को कोई और रिक्वायरमेंट है. वी ऑल्सो बिल्ड डैशबोर्ड्स विद गवर्नमेंट एंड ऑपरेटर्स, दैट यू वांट टू सी कि कितने टिकट्स कटे, कितने रुपए आए हैं, डिजिटल कितना था, कैश ट्रांजेक्शन कितना है. इट शोज इन डैशबोर्ड ऑल द टाइम. सो कमांड कंट्रोल सेंटर वी आर सेटिंग अप विद गवर्नमेंट, वी आर मैनेजिंग देयर क्रू. So, mm-hmm. in for example, Nagpur mein,
mm-hmm.
we are managing entire crew also,
mm-hmm.
the field staff, fleet staff, because Nagpur wanted that way,
yeah.
that we need leak-free buses.
Mm-hmm.
So, these are the things, and when we go and talk about international, International is also similar kind of models wherein we go to Philippines or Peru or Lima. These are the states and cities wherein we saw the similar problems people are facing. Mm-hmm. In fact, sometimes, you know, poorer than us services.
Mm-hmm.
So those are potential markets wherein you can create a lot of impact and change lives.
Mm-hmm.
So that's how it is.
Currently, how many markets are you present
in? We are in like around 66 cities.
Okay.
But in international, we are in Philippines, Peru, Bangkok, Manila.
Mm-hmm.
And we are exploring one more country, which we will get.
How has the experience sort of been as a female co-founder? Especially talk us through that, because one of the points that you mentioned was also how one board member realized your potential and asked, you know, Mohit to give you a better position in the company as well. So talk me through that entire journey, and also for you know, younger entrepreneurs watching the show, right? Give some advice that you want to share.
I would say that he said that give her better opportunity.
Mm-hmm.
I would say that this was more of a role fit,
better
right?
Fit.
What you are doing, so for this organization, culture and people are very important, very important.
Right.
So whoever is leading, that person suddenly automatically becomes very strong.
Mm-hmm.
And I have been in a very strong position when I was heading entire people function.
Yeah.
So it was not a, theek hai, yaar, HR hai, de do inko, aisa wala, bilkul bhi case nahi hai is company mein. Na hi kar wale mein tha, na chalo mein hai. But when somebody sees that, okay, this person can do a lot more than what this person is doing.
Yeah.
So it was not about gender, I think.
Mm-hmm.
It was all about how you are as a personality.
Mm. And the advice that you would want to give young entrepreneurs, both male and female, from your experience that you've had running all these companies so far.
I think if I was running, and I'm going to be speaking unfiltered now.
Mm-hmm.
If I was running alone, it would have been tougher, right? Because you have male co-founders and they have been successful and I also have been successful.
Yeah.
It became easier for me.
Yeah.
But I still feel that if some female wants to run the organization and she wants to start something, her life is much more harder than a 26-year-old male who wants to build something like some company, and they do a very bad job of it, but they still get funding. But females, and it's not about only entrepreneurship, it's about on jobs also, like there are research which says that I will check your potential and credibility and education, right? And when you are coming for interview, and I'll still pay you less. But when men comes for interview, I'll see that confidence, conviction, and how confidently they are saying that they are going to get it done, whether they know or whether they don't know.
Yeah.
It's unfortunate. And it's not only India, it's around the world. So I think it's always good to build a strong founding team.
What is your way of, you know, coping through the ups and downs?
I think good thing about life is that every night has a morning. So no matter what, and I'm genuinely telling you, no matter what happens today, you sleep. Right? And you got another morning to do something and make things better for yourself and others, and try. Just try, because it happens when you try.
I think this is a very good advice and a very good place to end our conversation. Thank you so much for talking to me today. You have shared a very interesting way of living life as well, I guess, for our viewers. Thank you so much. Thank you, Priya.
Thank you.
It was
thank
great
so
talking
much.
To
it
you.
Was